So now I'm going to ask Greg to come back and talk a little bit about our study commission.
And I'll invite us to do a little housekeeping quickly. So if you're a delegate in the House, may I have you raise your voting card right now? Excellent. So as a reminder, it is difficult for your tri-moderators to see outside of these kind of first four sections. There's a lot of empty seats kind of in this section here and a lot in this section here. If you could move in a little bit easier, it will make it easier for us to scan the room when we're doing an official vote. So if you have some time right now, just move in, make new friends. You can still leave a seat or two in between folks if you need to, but you know, there's enough space. So I thank you for that. Our bylaws anticipate that promises need to be revisited from time to time. And that's exactly what our principles, sources, purposes are. They're promises, they're a covenant among our congregations in association. And so to avoid becoming a creed, we are required to revisit all of Article 2 at least once every 15 years. We can do that much more frequently if we'd like, and we've tried a few times. We tried about 5 years ago, most recently, or maybe 9 years ago, it was a little bit longer than that. And we obviously began some great conversations with the bylaw amendment proposals in the past few days and in the months leading up to that. So the conversation began when the congregation said, hey, we should get this to the agenda. It sounds to me, and it sounds to your board, like we really want to have a conversation about who we are to one another, who we are inside of our congregations, and who we are for everyone else in the world. To that end, again, we're required to do this at least once every 15 years. We did not establish a study commission yesterday. We thought we might. We thought we might, and well, maybe that's not the full truth. We briefly established a study commission and then said we didn't need it. That's what we actually did. We had that 4/5 vote, so we established the study commission, and then it went out of existence almost as quickly. Article 15.1 of our bylaws allows your board of trustees, which is in fact the General Assembly in between General Assemblies, that's who we are, we're all of you, we're all of your congregations in association, to establish a study commission at any point, and mandates that the commission must be established if it's been longer than 15 years. So we're gonna do that. Because we really wanna have some conversations about who we are right now, and we've been doing such great work with the Renewing Covenant Task Force that it's a really great time to start thinking about what are some of the different potentials we have. What if who we said we are wasn't part of our bylaws? What if it existed in a different theological document that wasn't subject to up and down voting? How do you feel about that? Do you think that the best way to be in covenant is to vote on the covenant using Robert's Rules of Order? We don't think so either, but it's time to start having a conversation about that, because once upon a time we did. That's why we did it. That's why it lives in our bylaws right now. We used to have different principles. Have you read our 1961 bylaws? We used to have a totally different view of what we were supposed to do. We said part of our mission was to make sure we were growing more congregations. That's what our 1961 bylaws say. We're going to go out there and make more Unitarian Universalist congregations. By 1985, I guess we thought we had enough. I'm not exactly sure why that one disappeared, but it did. But we got new and cleverer language that invited us to draw from sources of a living tradition and gave us principles that applied those sources of our living tradition, and then went one further and said, all of these things we agree to, if you don't really believe that, you don't have to. That's what 2.3 says, Article 2.3. That's your freedom of belief clause. If there's anything that is morally objectionable in the rest of Article 2, you don't have to do that. So these are conversations. Conversations we want to start. I'm going to invite you for just a second to turn to someone near you, preferably someone you don't necessarily know. What are some of the conversations you would like us to have about our identity? I'm going to give you 3 minutes to do this. 3 minutes. What are conversations you want to have about our identity? Let's begin wrapping up our conversations. I'm really excited by the energy I hear. Wonderful. So this is the work that a study commission can do. They're going to invite us into deeper conversation. The study commission itself doesn't hold the only conversations. As a matter of fact, the mandate requires that they do broad outreach to all of our congregations. Wouldn't it be awesome if every time we made decisions, we made sure that we reached out to every single congregation, not only the ones that can show up? We're going to do that. It's going to take a year or two or four, says the former moderator corner. Give me a moment. But we're going to take some time to do this and do it right and make sure that before it's time to make the decision, we've had enough time to get all the voices heard. so that we know that it's a decision that we want to make together.